Okay, this is Jerry Jenkins. This is an update to a video I did about 6 months ago. There's a new version of Python out, and Windows has changed a little, and so has PyCharm. So this video is how to install the new version of Python into Windows 10, and also the most popular IDE for working with it, which is PyCharm. So we're going to start by making sure we don't already have it installed. I've had users in my previous videos have problems because it was already installed. So we're just going to go to the Windows search box and type uninstall. And you should it should bring up the Add Remove Programs choice here. Click on that. And where it says search list, we're just going to type PY. It should limit the list to just things that start with PY. And we want to uninstall these two things. So I'll go ahead and do that, and I'll speed up the video for this. Okay, so they're all uninstalled, so I'm going to close this window. And so now we're ready to install Python. So I'm going to go to Microsoft Edge. You can use any browser. And go to the page python.org, and you just want to go to downloads and hover your mouse over that, and then move it down and onto this button. It's going to choose the appropriate Python for the machine you're on. It'll correctly choose 32-bit or 64-bit. Be aware that 32-bit really runs on most systems fine, so we'll go ahead and hit run. Now notice, this is a new thing in Windows I've noticed. If my window were bigger, you wouldn't see this back window here. You'll notice the icons show up, but the back window would be invisible. So a lot of times you have to click this new icon that popped up to pop the window up above the browser. For some reason the browser stays on top of everything. So I'm going to close the browser. Now we want to make sure we check Add Python 3.8. This allows it to run from command or PowerShell. And it also, if you don't click this, it may not work with IDEs like PyCharm. And just click install now and click yes to the security question. And that's it. We're going to hit close. We'll try it out in the command line, cmd. And you can also do PowerShell, and we're going to type Python hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. It should tell you what version, so we know it's installed. So now we're going to install PyCharm. So we're going to go to Edge again, and we're in the Bing browser. We're going to search for PyCharm, which is called PyCharm. Now what we're looking for, you may get this in a different order because now Bing and Google give you ads first, so you may not get this first, but you want to look for the www.jetbrains link and click on it. And let me expand this a little bit. Okay, so go ahead and just click download here. It comes in two versions. Again, this will detect the computer you're on, so it's correctly detected I'm in Windows 10. It has a professional version that you normally pay for, and a community version which is completely free. The professional version, if you don't want to pay for it and you're a student, if you go look in the buy area and look under education, you can see that if you have a .edu student address ending in .edu, or you have an international student card, you can get this free. In fact, you can get all of the JetBrains products, which are very good if you do filament in other languages or do web development. We're going to download the community edition, so go ahead and click here. And then hit run. Now again, Windows has a pop-up window, but you don't see it because it's behind the browser. But you can see the new security icon here. Click on this and go ahead and say yes. And You can close the browser at this point. And we see the install for PyCharm. So just click Next. Click Next. And you may want to have a launcher on your desktop, so that's an option. And you may want to associate any Python file which ends in .py to open up this application. So I usually don't check these, but that's your choice. Go ahead and hit Next. And hit Next or Install. I'll speed this part up. And we'll go ahead and run it by clicking this button and hit Finish. It'll open up a new copy of PyCharm Community Edition. Now remember, if you had your browser open, it may put this window behind your browser again. That's why I closed the browser. We're just going to go ahead. It's never been installed before, so we have this. Hit OK. And it gives a choice of a dark or a light theme. I'm going to choose the light theme for this. Just skip the remaining steps, which is actually going to ask if you want some plugins. And we're ready. So when you first open up PyCharm, you get this every time if you don't have a project open. A project is basically a folder where you put all your programs for a specific project. You can open an existing project here. This is something that if you're using version control, like from GitHub, if you know what that is, this is where you'd set it up. If you're new, you can ignore that. We're going to ignore configure, unlike my original demo. We're just going to say create a new project. So here's where you create a new project. Be aware of two things. One, PyCharm is going to try to insist you use what's called a virtual environment. So let me show you what that is. Let me talk about the name of the project first. So this is where it creates it. It created a folder for you in your user directory called PyCharm Projects. And I use that as the default, but you can change the default of where you store your projects, or you can have more than one area. You can just navigate to it here. But the last thing that's highlighted is the name of the new project. This is a folder that it's going to create for the new project. So I'm going to call it the Hello Project. Okay. And then you pull down the interpreter here, and it says new environment using virtual environment. And this is what PyCharm tries to force you to do. It's going to create a folder inside of your project called vEnvironment. And what that is going to do is it's going to be a virtual environment that points to where we installed Python. And if you add any features to your environment, it isolates the changes you make from the system interpreter. I don't find this easy for beginners, because every time you make a new project, it creates a separate folder, and those folders are kind of large because they have a lot in them, and you don't need this as a beginner. So we're going to just use the existing interpreter. So all you have to do is click down here, and then go click on this dot dot dot, and you're going to choose System Interpreter. And you'll notice it picks where our system interpreter is. And by the way, this is where you can find out where it is at any time. And hit OK. So now when it makes the project, it says use the existing interpreter, don't make a new environment. That's what you want. I'm about to show you how to make that the default every time you make a project. And this is what took me a long time to figure out, because it doesn't tell you in any of the documentation. But first you have to make a project. So first we do this, hit Create. Now, whenever you open a new project, you'll see this window. This is the shows you the project structure, and it's all in Hello. This is tips for how to use PyCharm. You can just close this; it'll come up every time you create a new project. You can always get to it from the Help menu. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to set it up for any future projects use the existing interpreter. So we do this before we write any code. Go to File, go to where you'll see Settings, and below that you'll see Other Settings. This is new in PyCharm, and we're going to set Settings for New Projects. And what we'll want to do is click on where it says Project Interpreter. Try this, and see it has the existing interpreter. which is the system interpreter. So you're going to click that and then say OK. So now for any new project, it's going to choose that when you make the new project. Okay, now let's actually program something. So we're going to right click on hello, say new Python file, and we'll give it a name. We'll just call it hello, same as the project. It's automatically going to put an extension on it, so we don't have to put .py at the end. You'll see here it is, .py, so I can write a comment, my first program, and then we'll print quote hello. Now if you do things wrong, you'll see little squigglies and you'll see little marks over here. So there's new, it likes a new line at the end of the file, so we'll click that. Now to run the project, this is normally where you run it, but it's grayed out. That's because we haven't told it what program to run, because normally you have a project, you may have multiple PY files, so there's going to be a main one. So to set the main one, you right click in the middle of the file and go ahead and run it. The easy way to set it, it'll run it, it prints hello, and now the green button's up, so we can run it again. If I change this to hello programmers and we hit the screen button, now it'll run this file. So if we create more files by right-clicking hello, if we have a Python that has multiple files, it's now set up to run as the main file this program, so this file. Now just to point out, Python console is the equivalent of idle, so instead of using idle, you can do it right here. Terminal is just like going to the command prompt, except it I think it knows Linux commands. Nope, it's just like you're in the command prompt. So you can run stuff directly from here, or you can get a directory. It actually lands you in the directory for your project. And so you're all set. This is how you use PyCharm. So enjoy. If you have any comments or questions, please comment on the video for this. And please subscribe to my channel.